Republican Representative Matt Gaetz found himself in a world of trouble this week after it was revealed through a Politico report that he had allegedly misused taxpayer funds to do a couple of personal things for himself. Here they are. There's two big ones in this report. The first one is he allegedly hired a personal speechwriting consultant, which is expressly forbidden by the rules of the United States House of Representatives. You are not allowed as a member of the House to hire a speechwriting consultant. And obviously you sure as hell can't do it with tax dollars. You can't expect the taxpayers to foot the bill for an individual representative's speechwriter, right? That doesn't make any sense. But allegedly that's what Matt Gaetz did. But this isn't just any speechwriter. By the way, this is a former member of the Trump administration, a man by the name of Darren Beatty, who was let go from the Trump administration after it was revealed that he had been attending white nationalist rallies. So, totally racist dude. Matt Gaetz sees that he gets fired for being racist and says, you know what? I think that's the kind of fella I would like writing speeches for me. Smart move, man. Smart move. As one of your constituents here in Florida's 1st District, I gotta tell you, that's not ever what I want to see my representative do, and I hope you get removed from the House of Representatives for doing that. Now, on to the second issue. And this is one that, believe it or not, we here at Ring of Fire might actually be kind of partially responsible for. Matt Gaetz apparently built his own television studio because he just loves going on TV so much. And he did it in his father's house. Hired a private company to do it. Used taxpayer dollars to hire that private company for his own TV studio in his daddy's house, so that he, and pretty much only he, could go on TV. And I got to read the rest of this. I got to read it directly from Politico. Taxpayers foot the bill to rent the television camera, and the private company that built the studio, which Gaetz refuses to identify, takes a fee each time he appears on the air. It's unclear how much it costs the private company to construct the studio. This may run afoul of the House gift rule, which prohibits any lawmaker, aide, and their family members from accepting gifts worth more than $50. Now, the reason I say Ring of Fire might partially be responsible for this is because, believe it or not, here in Florida's 1st District, not a whole lot of television studios. In fact, for the longest time, there was only one, but then there was two. And that second one was us here at Ring of Fire. We had the cameras, we had the equipment to be able to connect not via satellite, but via fiber. And Gaetz's office would frequently request the use of our studio. And we would always politely turn him down. We don't typically like to rent out our studio to people. So that's the way we do. And a lot of times it would, you know, interfere with what we were already doing. We were using it, so we couldn't accommodate Matt Gaetz. Another studio actually opened up in a restaurant about two blocks away. And so Gaetz had been using that, but then he decided to make his own. So that's why I say I kind of feel partially responsible for this. Not that I'm saying we're involved in any of his transgressions here, because this does sound highly illegal. You use tax dollars to build a studio, a TV studio, and I know because I've overseen the construction of at least three of them, those are incredibly expensive. Those aren't cheap. The cameras that are required are not cheap. The internet connection that is required for an LTN or TVU device to connect to these networks, that's not cheap either. The monthly fee on those is not cheap. This is costing a lot of money. And given the fact that you own the studio, technically, it's in your dad's house, you friggin' own it. Anyone charging a fee to use it, that's insane. That's insane. That is profiteering. That is in your dad's house. He owns the studio. This warrants a massive investigation because Matt Gaetz is ripping us off. You know, this, I know the TV studio business pretty well because I've been in it for quite a while. I know what it entails. I know where the payments go. And I know for a fact that when somebody comes along and builds it, after they build it, you pay them for it and they don't get fees. That money is definitely going to his daddy. Has to be. It's his house. A full-scale investigation is warranted here. If we can get Matt Gaetz out of office and back into jail where he should have gone years ago? Maybe, just maybe, this little district where I'm sitting in, sun might shine a little brighter on us in the future. I know we kind of, you know, we screwed up by giving everybody Matt Gaetz, but maybe we get some good investigators on this, we can finally right that wrong.